My name is Deborah Clemens, and I am the founder and CEO of Infusion Blends, Flavored Butters.
Hi, and I'm Henry Mason Jr., and I'm a partner here at Infusion Blends.
So our business is in the manufacturing of flavored butters, what we use to cook with. You can use them as a spread, you can use them as a marinade. We have 12 different flavors of butters, and they're all natural, all infused, and it's all in the butter. And when we say it's all in the butter, that means it's all in the butter. We put special herbs, fruit, real fruit, and seasoning in the butter, so that's the only thing you have to use. You don't even have to use salt. At the end of the day, if you can put butter on it, you can put infusion blends on it.
Absolutely, and what I love about it the most is that you can take the everyday person, the average Joe like myself, and we can become gourmet chefs overnight. We just take the butter, put it on your favorite meats and vegetables, and voila, you got your favorite four-course dinner right in front of you. Here at Infusion Blends, we're asking for $250,000 for 25% of our company, and also for a $100,000 line of credit.
And what we're gonna use that money for is for equipment, so that we have an automated system to do production. We're also gonna use it for advertising and marketing to drive people into the stores to buy our product. And we're also going to use the line of credit to help reduce the cost of raw materials that we can buy in larger bulk.
Absolutely. And what's really, really important is that we're already in 49 grocery stores across the Southeast, and with Kroger, and then we're talking about Walmart.
Okay. We got a wonderful thing happening, which is really why we want you guys involved, is I had a meeting with the dairy buyer for Walmart 2 weeks ago, and he's very excited about the product. He wants to bring in infusion blends into an initial 500 plus Walmart stores. And so we have a lot of flavors. We can make more flavors so we can keep the line new and exciting. People love the jars because they recycle them after. I had one customer call me up and say they use it to put safety pins in. So it's recyclable, it has another life longer than the butter after they eat it all.
Yeah, and also too, just I guess you kind of explain a little bit how we met and your aha moment. Where did it come from?
The whole idea, I like to cook. I like to eat. I'm sorry. I love food. I love to eat. But I love my food to be seasoned well. Right. And so my best friend, his mom, had cancer. And I used to cook for her. She's a three-time cancer survivor. Yeah. And she loves the butter. So she started, I started cooking for her. And I had this rub that I would use, that I made up, that I would use for the steaks and any meats that she wanted to use, and I'd cook it. One day I got lazy and I said, okay, let me take the butter, because at steakhouse, the best steakhouse, always puts butter on steaks. Yeah. So then I said, okay, I'm lazy, I don't feel like it. I put the butter in it together and gave it to her, I rolled it up, and she started cooking for herself. Now you gotta mind you, this is where the whole idea of this product comes from. She does not cook. She calls me up and she says, you know, I went to my refrigerator and I was going to saute some vegetables and I saw your butter and I just decided just to throw them in there. She goes, oh my God, it was so good. And I'm like, really? You had food in your refrigerator? But no, she did, and she started cooking with it more and more for herself. And the night she called me up, I put it into the marinara sauce for my spaghetti. Oh, I sauteed some rice with it. So that's when I went, interesting. And I started making flavors and selling them to friends and family. And I would come up with flavors that everybody can identify with. You know, you say, oh, I want some truffle butter. Who knows what to do with truffle butter? I don't. But I know what I can do when I say I got peach butter. Ooh, I can add it to my peach cobbler. Mm. You know, things like that. So I come up with flavors that are very familiar to the masses that you want to eat. And once people taste it, they're done. You're sold. I mean, Henry here just tasted the newest flavor, and what did you think?
It was amazing. it was amazing. And I think too, with the butters here, it's more than anything, everything you need is here. So you literally just go to the store. For me, like, I work, right? And I leave and I go home, and I just, like, I don't want to cook, and sometimes I don't even have time to really go to a restaurant. This is so much better, because for the fraction of a price, I can go to a grocery store, grab a chicken breast, grab some string beans, put it in a pan, put it in with this butter, and it tastes like I just got a meal from the restaurant. And that's why it's absolutely phenomenal. So it's full circle, right?
Right, that's why we call it's all in the butter. And that's what it means. All the seasoning, all the flavors in the butter. The butter is a conduit for the seasoning. And that's why it's all natural. We use real fruit. We use spices and herbs. There's nothing preservatives. We use all natural butters. There's no GMO. So it's a nice, clean label, clean product. And you, when you use it, and I say it's all in the butter, you actually taste like a restaurant cooks your food.
Absolutely.
And here you are, a novice cook, y'all. You got to do is pop the top and become a gourmet chef in seconds. So that's our product. And I can't wait for you guys to taste it, because we did send over some samples. So you're going to get a chance to love these butters and understand and feel them for yourself. So what makes this product interesting? And
what makes it interesting to you?
What makes it
better or more unique than other products?
What makes Infusion Blends butter unique and better than other products is, first of all, the eyesight. It is the packaging.
Yeah.
The packaging is absolutely beautiful and it's unique, it's different. In fact, I've landed a lot of deals just on the packaging alone. And especially what makes it more, it stays fresher longer, it stays neater longer in the jar. So that's one of the reasons why, but also it's what's in the jar. It's just as important as what's outside of that jar. And what's in that jar is packed full of flavor. You only need a little bit and it goes a long way. So our savory butters are complex. Almost every single butter that we make has at least 6 to 12 different ingredients in it. So it's very complex. So when you want to use a peach butter, for example, on a piece of toast or put into your oatmeal to sweeten it up, it works. But if you want to use that same peach butter to bake a ham as a glaze, or you want to use it to saute some cabbage, it works. So in the flavor profile, which is really interesting, like if you take the rosemary butter, you can put in one meal, you can do your rice, you can do your meat, you can do your veggies, and the beautiful thing about it, it doesn't taste the same. And you would think that, oh, I can still taste your rosemary butter. It's like the tofu butter. Whatever you put it with, it's going to enhance it. So when I look at other compound butters, they're not as complex. They can't saute at high temperatures. So we use a very high and grade of butter. It has a lot of butter fat, so it doesn't burn as quickly. They're not taking a complex recipe. And the process by which we do it, which is a secret, but the process by how we make the butter is determines how that butter is going to actually melt, how that butter is going to taste, how it's going to feel in your mouth. So that makes us unique. And the fact that we actually have a line of butters that are flavorful but are different. So that's where the uniqueness comes from.
So far now, we spent about $180,000 on the business. Some of it was upfront costs, of course, but also it's important to note that this is a product business. So we actually take some of the money that we do make from our profits and put it right back into the business. So a lot of times we're constantly buying new supplies just to make sure we have those things available. So if new orders, when they do come in, we can actually go in and do it. And with the tariffs and things, sometimes we have to be on top of these things. So we had to come actually use money that we had and buy some of these supplies earlier than we normally would have.
Right.
But we have to do it just because things are running low. But go ahead.
Yes, and I'm going to share something very interesting in how I even came about doing this. I mean, yeah, it started out not as, oh, I want to start a business, but it started out as, I want to help a friend. Mm-hmm. And that's, you know, very powerful when, you know, your business is not started out just by, I want to make tons of money, but I wanted to make a difference in somebody else's life. It changed my life, and it changed somebody else's life, and that's what's important to me. And, you know, I want to be able to leave behind a legacy for my family that, you know, hey, I was here and I created something that didn't exist before, which is like kind of tickles. And it feels great to know that that's something that I have contributed to this world and contributed to a very good.